Hey, Chill Bell gang, it's your girl. So real quick, I just wanted to do a quick little wig review from samsbeauty.com. I'm actually in between units. I'm washing my regular unit that's human hair. So I just wanted to try this quick half up, half down unit that I actually do like. So stay tuned for the voiceover and then stay tuned for the end for my actual thoughts on the unit. You already know what it is. Hit subscribe. Tell me what you want to see below. I have a lot more hairstyle, lifestyle, fashion hauls, and DIYs coming up. So please join the Chill Bell gang and make sure you comment. Hit me up on Instagram and let's roll the intro. Chill Bell gang, we're back. So this unit is really nice, but you see I'm gonna cut it because it's just way too long for me. So I'm about 5'6". I'm just gonna cut it just a little bit. Nothing serious, nothing too precise. Just gonna cut it on each side. And this unit actually cut a lot better than most synthetic wigs I have had. So that's a plus. And you see when you cut it, it just looks fuller automatically because I felt like the ends were a little bit too thin. And some people can carry off really, really long hair, but this was just the perfect length for me. All right, we'll be right back. Okay. All right, gotta get some coffee. Yummy. All right, let's go to the next step. Get our got to be glue gel, get our blow dryer. And you don't need a strong adhesive. The only reason why is because this is a synthetic wig. It's made of imitation fiber. So you don't need something that is just gonna stay on your head because it's going to tangle, mat, and frizz. So we don't want something that's too strong, but we want something to kind of hold the hairline down. So I'm just taking my little applicator and just going along the hairline. So this hairline was a little bit straight. I noticed with human hair wigs, they're more customizable. This one, not so much. So that may kind of cause some difficulty for some people if they have, you know, a hairline that's a little bit different. But this doesn't look as realistic. This hairline is kind of just straight across, as you can see, but we're gonna make it work. I mean, this unit was $25, so you know, expectations. All right, I'm just making sure I get a good amount of gel, but not too much. All right, let's straighten it up, kind of press it down. I like the luster of this hair. It's not too shiny. That was the one thing that reminded me of the human hair kind of imitation. It wasn't too shiny like a lot of synthetic wigs are. I'm just gonna press and blow dry on a cool setting just to kind of get that thing kind of, you know, secured. All right, everybody has a scarf. Let's tie that down. Okay, I'll just leave it down, like, you know, maybe 10 or 15 minutes, do some housework around the house, call your friend, do something else. I'm just combing it to show you guys, you know, what kind of snags I get. It's actually not too bad. And I really didn't get a lot of hairs in the comb either. I was kind of shocked. All right, one moment. Okay, we're just gonna do a quick blow dry. Listen, we're trying to get this wig secured. And I will say that this wig, as I will say at the end of the video, is not big head friendly. So I had to kind of just work with what I could. okay, let's see what we can do with these baby hairs. These baby hairs were kind of stiff, not even gonna hold you. They were not soft at all. I actually cut them quite a bit. So I was trying to do what I could to kind of lay them down. If you have any suggestions, drop a comment below, let me know. But they were very hard. So I'm just taking my gel too, along with the mousse, seeing if I can lay it down. Of course, with a human hair wig, it's so much easier. So much easier. But I feel like you need some type of baby hair to soften this straight hairline. So I was doing the best that I could. If only you knew, like, I was trying to maintain a calm face, but I was low-key irritated. So let's see what we can do. Here goes our handy dandy scarf. What would we do without them again? Let's see what we can do with this baby hair. All right, be right back. Okay, we're finally back. So I just wanted to give you guys some quick thoughts on this wig from Sam's Beauty. Just some quick little details real quick for it. It is from samsbeauty.com and the unit was $25.99. It comes in all different colors. And of course, like I said in the video, it comes in a half up, half down. There is a part right over here and it extends to the back where you can kind of see where they try to do the half up, half down thing. And the good thing about this too is obviously you can take the top knot down. They have it in a pretty blonde color too, if that's not your thing. Now, a couple of things about this unit. The hairline is, again, this is a synthetic unit, so we're only gonna get so much out of it, sis, but it is, it's kind of straight across. It's not like a real hairline that you're used to with human hair wigs. So you're gonna have to get used to that. You saw that I cut the wig. It was just way too long to me. And I'm almost 5'6", and it was like, you saw how long it was when I was cutting it. But I think it kind of gave it more of a quality look when I cut it just a little bit. There are people who can carry out that long look, but it's just not me. So this is called the Dottie wig and it's a synthetic wig. So, I mean, you're only gonna get what you know, so much, sis. We really can't expect miracles. But as I'm combing it through, it's not that bad. I mean, I am getting those regular snags in the back. And I got mine in a number one because I love that jet black color. But they have a lot of other colors. Burgundy, they have the 613 blonde. Okay, so the other thing I would say about this unit is the baby hairs. The baby hairs were, for me, and please put a comment below if you kind of were able to tame them, they were very hard to manipulate. It's not even the fact that they were thick, because you can always customize them and cut them down. It's just that when I got the wig, they were like curled into the hairline, so it was flipped this way. And it was just hard to kind of just get them to cooperate. And for this type of hairline, I believe like you need baby hairs to kind of camouflage that harshness with it just being like this. So that was one thing that I would say. So maybe just kind of like put a strong gel on it, like your gots to be glue, and kind of just put your scarf on for about an hour, because I don't know what it is. Maybe it's because it's synthetic baby hair, but it just wouldn't lay down. If you have any tips, let me know. I'm not Arrogant Tay, clearly. I'm not Alonzo. I'm just a girl that likes to just switch it up from time to time. So I'm not an expert at, you know, laying these type of things down. So I can do what I can. The third thing is, as you saw in the video, when I was gluing the hair down with the Gots to Be glue, it's not big haired friendly. I'm not even going to cap you. It's just not. Most people have small, cute little heads. I'm the one with the big head. It was a little bit of a struggle to kind of like get this down. And it still flaps up right here. It just, you see how my hairline is right here? It, sis, I can't even pull it down. I can't. And you know, it's okay. It's okay. We don't want to like tack down synthetic wigs anyway, because they tend to get tangled. We just want to like, you know, wear them for a cocktail, a drink, you know, a concert, and then put them back in the closet. So you can see even right here, it just wouldn't fit. For some other people, it'll fit perfectly. Actually, for most people, it'll fit perfectly. But for me, no. So that's the other thing. The other thing is this half up, half down is, of course, my friends and everybody know I love half up, half downs. It's kind of loose. It's kind of loose. It's almost like it's if I, you know, it's going to fall out. It could fall out. And it's, I wish it was tighter. I'm not even going to take it down, because the more you mess with synthetic hair, the more it kind of, it can kind of get tangled on you and frizz up. So I'm going to leave it like this. I don't mind. Like I said, this wig will get you through a day, you know, when you're just want something new. And that's what synthetic wigs are for. They're not for something you just install with got to be glue. It's not for that. It's not for the regular install. It's just for, you know, like I did the gel real quick, tied my scarf down, and we're good to go. So overall, I would say, so my rating for this wig would be probably like a strong 8.5. You know, it's $25. It's $25. I mean, it's not, you're not going to get the best hairline. You're not going to get, you know, this luxurious hair. It's synthetic hair is nothing but plastic fiber. That's all it is to it. So, I do like that it has a healthy sheen to it, but it's not too shiny. So I do like that. Let me know what you guys think in the comments. Comment below any other unit you want me to review, any other companies you think I should buy from. Again, this was purchased with my own money from samsbeauty.com. And I think I want to do more of these, because we're in quarantine, back and forth, in and out of quarantine. And it's a good time to kind of like just, you know, just try some new stuff. So I'm looking forward to the next hair review. If you have a suggestion, let me know. If you haven't subscribed, what are you doing? It's, the family is growing every week, and I really appreciate y'all love and support. Let me see what else I have. Let's see. Turn your post notifications on, and more videos will be coming, especially with DIYs. I love you guys. Have a good day. Bye. Chill gang, it's your girl. So I just was kind of bored in the house, and I thought, why not do a quick wig review from samsbeauty.com. and I'm kind of in between units. I'm washing my regular unit, so I was like, why not try this unit out. I'm just gonna do a quick voiceover, blah blah,
oh, you should know that.